Okay, so this is the question I said we are going to look at on Venn diagrams. We started Venn diagrams last time and we looked at one question. So our question says a group of Zambian students were asked which neighboring countries, Malawi, Botswana and Zimbabwe, they had visited. The information below was obtained. 8 visited Malawi, 7 visited Botswana, 55 visited Zimbabwe, 36 visited both Malawi and Botswana, 30 visited both Malawi and Zimbabwe, 30 visited Zimbabwe, 10 visited all the 3 countries. Illustrate this information in a Venn diagram. This is our first question. How many students took part in the survey? So we are going to answer these questions using the information given. How many visited Botswana only, one country only, Malawi and Zimbabwe only, at least 2 countries? So now, what I want you to learn from here is how to put this information in a Venn diagram. That's what I want you to learn. Putting this information that we have in a Venn diagram is the most important thing. And then when you are done, you'll be able to answer these other questions here. So 10 students visited all the countries. So you come and put your 10 here. You go to these other intersections. These. For those who visited 2 countries. So first, you fill in the blank for those who visited all the countries, all of them. In this case, there are 10, so that's the first one that you put. You put 10 there. And then you go to those who are visiting 2 countries. 6 visited both Malawi and Botswana. So Malawi and Botswana. 6 people visited Malawi and Botswana. So when you come to your Venn diagram here, Malawi and Botswana is here. This is where the intersection is. Botswana, Malawi, the intersection is here. So what you do is, you don't get this 36 and put it there the way it is. So you subtract this 10 that you already have here from the 36. So you say 36 minus 10, which will give you 26. And it's the 26 that you put here. Okay? So the question says 36 students visited both Malawi and Botswana. 36 visited both. So you don't get the 36 and you come and put there. But instead what you do is, since you already have 10 who visited all the countries, you will do 36 minus 10. And that's why I've written it here. 36 minus 10, and then it's the 26 that you put there. Then you go to the next one. You do the same. The next one says 30 visited both Malawi and Zimbabwe. 30 visited both Malawi and Zimbabwe. Malawi and Zimbabwe. 30 visited. So you look for the intersection for Malawi and Zimbabwe, which is this one here. Malawi is here, Zimbabwe is here, so the intersection is here. So what you do is you subtract also. Since you have 30 here, you do now 30 minus this 10 here. So you always subtract this 10, eh? So 30 minus 10, which will give you 20. And it's the 20 that you come and put here. Okay, so for purposes of not forgetting, this 30 minus 10, if you want, you can even put it in there. You say 30 minus 10. That would be fine, so that you easily remember what we are doing here. Then you go to the next one. 30 visited Zimbabwe and Botswana. Yes, Zimbabwe and Botswana is here. So they are also 30. So Zimbabwe and Botswana. 30 people visited. So you do the same. Yes, so you do 30 minus 10, which will give you the 20 that we have. And then you put 20 there. And then when you are done with the intersections, you now come to these parts here. These ones. So you come to these ones here. So you come to the first one which says Eite visited Malawi. Yes, Eite visited Malawi. Eite visited Malawi. So you go to that circle which represents Malawi. You go to the circle that represents Malawi, which is this one here. This is the circle that represents Malawi. This one. So what you do now for you to find for this one, you add everything in that circle. So you are going to do for Malawi, you will do 26 plus 10 plus 20. Yes, you get 56. You get 56. 56. And then after getting your 56, you subtract it from the 80 that you have. So you will do 80 minus 56, which will give you 24. And it's the 24 that you are going to put for Malawi. So 24 here. And then from there you go to the next one, you do the same. 7 days visited Botswana. So you come to Botswana now. Botswana. So 7 days visited Botswana. So you go to the circle for Botswana. The circle that represents Botswana. So Botswana is this circle here. Here is the circle for Botswana. And then you are going to add everything in that circle. You are going to have 20 plus 10 plus 26, which will give us 56 also. And then after doing this, you subtract from the 70 that has been given there. So you say, okay, 70 minus 56.
No,
it's 70. Here, 70 distance, but one. Yes, so you subtract here, then you end up with 14 for Botswana, and then you come and put the 14 here. Then the last one is for Zimbabwe. You go to Zimbabwe, you find the statement which says 55 visited Zimbabwe. What represents Zimbabwe is this one here. This is the circle for Zimbabwe. So you add all these numbers here. You are going to have 20 plus 10 plus 20, which will give you 50, okay? And then you subtract from the total number given. You say, therefore, for Zimbabwe, you are going to have 55 minus 50, which will give you 5, yes. And then you put 5 here. You put 5. And once you do this, it means you have completed the Venn diagram. So there are only a few things that you follow here. Just a revision on what we have done so far. We are saying the first part that you complete is here for those who do everything. Those who visited all the countries. And that was 10. And then after that, you come to these intersections here. So for this intersection, we had 30 who visited both Malawi and Zimbabwe. So you subtract this 10 here, 30 minus 10, you get 20. And you continue like that for everyone. Yes, I hear it, sir.
Oh, yes, sir. Is it possible for them not to give us the people that visited all the countries?
If you are not given those, then you are going to have a question like the one that I gave you in class. You remember that day?
Yes.
But in a question like this, we'll give you those who did everything. How many people took part in the survey? How many people took part? So for this one, you add everything that you can see here. Okay, you add everything that you can see here. You can see, so you are going to have 14 plus 26 plus 24. Plus 20, plus 10, plus 20, plus 5. And then when you add this, you are going to have, this is 40, this is 64, this is 84, 94, and then this is 114, 119. 119. Okay, so you have 119 people who took part in the survey. Okay? Part C of the question says how many visited Botswana only, and the answer is here 14. That's correct, 14. Then number 2 says how many have visited one country only. So for this one, you add these numbers here, 24 plus 14 plus 5. So 24 plus 14, which is 38 plus 5, which will give us
43.
Which will give us 43, yes. Then the next question says, how many visited Malawi and Zimbabwe only? Zimbabwe only is 20. Okay, so 20. Those are the ones who visited Malawi and Zimbabwe only. They are here? Yes. So it's this 20 here, not this one. This one here. Malawi and Zimbabwe. Then the next one says, how many visited at least two countries? How many visited at least two countries? So, the word at least simply means you check those who visited two countries only and those who visited three. At least means you start from two going up. So, in this case, we are going to add 20 plus 10 plus 20. So, 20 plus 10 plus 20 plus 26. Okay, all these numbers here. And then we are going to have 50 plus that one there, we have 76. We have 76, and here this is where we end for this question.